Remand detainees are individuals who have been arrested and are being held in correctional centers while awaiting trial. A report found by the Legal Aid Service Providers Network has indicated that 49.9% of the prisoners in the country currently are on remand without being tried. Some of the prisoners have been on remand for a period of 2 to 3 years without being tried.
My submission would be that throughout our investigations, one of the root causes is ignorance, if I'm to term it that way. Ignorance from these detainees, or most of our local population. Individuals are not acquainted or given civic education to acquaint them with more knowledge that they are supposed to be produced in courts of law in 48 hours. So in such a regard, they cannot even challenge police in that line. Two, impunity from some of the officers who are handling or manning these institutions. They well know that they are supposed to produce these suspects within 48 hours, but they just stand on their ground, especially in political cases.
Speaking during the National Dialogue on the Promotion and Protection of Procedural Rights of Pretrial Detainees in Kampala today, the Executive Director of Legal Aid Service Providers Network, Dr. Slavia Namubiru, has called upon the judiciary to recruit more lawyers, especially in the rural areas, to fight the case backlog in the country.
So you'll find that the lawyers are in Kampala, they are in Mbarara, yes, they are in Gulu, yes, you'll not find them in Lamo, you'll not find them in Agago, you'll not find them a few in Kitgum, like Uganda Law Society. When you go to the eastern Uganda, you'll find them in Tororo, you'll find them in Iganga, you'll find them in Jinja, but you won't find them in the districts beyond. You'll find them in Soroto, but you'll find a few in Moroto. And you'll find there one lawyer serving a population of thousands. One lawyer. The vulnerable are 80% of the Ugandan population that cannot afford free legal aid. Majority of the people in the prisons, the youth, are the poor. They cannot afford services of free, I mean, what? Practicing advocates.
It's a bigger issue. When access to justice, especially in rural areas, it's a bigger challenge. Even in urban areas, it's still a challenge, but in rural areas, it's even worse. The biggest solution we would have thought was the passing of the National Legal Aid Bill, which has been pending in Parliament for the last 4 or 5 years. And still government has no will to pass it because of the obligations. Because with that, if that law has passed, would ensure that government provides lawyers to everyone, even in rural areas.
The Deputy Solicitor General, Pius Biribonwa, reaffirmed the government's commitment to dispense justice. He expressed a need for Parliament to speed up the debate, which will see the National Legal Aid Bill become a law to enable the marginalized members of the public to get legal aid at a free charge. Biribonwa assured the prisoners on remand that they were not forgotten. He promised them that their trials are going to be speeded up.
We need to explore how to ensure that once a person is committed, the trial process should commence within the shortest time possible. To this end, we support the judiciary's initiative to have daily hearings of criminal cases at the High Court. This has been made possible with the increase in the number of judges who have been recruited and other judicial officers. We now have more High Court circuits. Moreover, the DPP has also recently, because I had this, I think, in the remarks made earlier, has only recently concluded a massive recruitment of state prosecutors. This has been a major problem, and we acknowledge that. I am certain that these interventions will soon bear fruit in ensuring that justice is not delayed.
According to the Uganda Prisons boss, Dr. Johnson Byabashaija, currently, Uganda prisons accommodate 76,222 inmates. Story compiled by Jaliet Namuwaya for the news.